happen in Hyderabad and choosing wisely. We've also held multiple meetings with all stakeholders, such as airlines, the airport operator, and we have ensured that SAFRAN was given the confidence from all stakeholders to get this MRO to Hyderabad. We were amongst the first state governments to represent to Government of India for rationalizing the GST on MRO to make Indian MRO industry globally competitive, because it's important to understand that this MRO in Hyderabad will not just cater to airlines in India. I am hopeful and I am very confident that a lot of Middle Eastern airlines will also send their planes here. I am also very confident that a lot of airlines based in Southeast Asia will also use this facility for all of their aircrafts as well. This new investment is a huge endorsement for the robustness of aerospace ecosystem in Hyderabad. I'm sure this will encourage other global aerospace and defense investors to choose Telangana for their Indian foray. What I'm even more happy about, you know, the three things that were mentioned by Olivier today. Of course, we have the two factories that have opened today, and the third investment that is announced today, MRO. He also announced a digital transformation center. Now, Hyderabad, as you all know, is an important technology hub in the country and one of the important technology hubs in the world. And with about 800 employees at the Digital Transformation Center for SAFRAN, this makes it the fourth investment of SAFRAN in about 6 years. And I think our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri KCR Garu, he always says one thing. He says, your existing investor in your state is your biggest brand ambassador. If they are happy, they are going to continue to expand their business. They are also going to ensure that the positivity about the state's ease of doing business, the positivity about the state's way of functioning, will reach every nook and corner in the world. And I think this is a resounding endorsement to the state of Telangana, as SAFRAN has announced its fourth project today. And I'm extremely thankful to you, Olivia, for your endorsement. Telangana today is the most vibrant and the happening aerospace valley in India. We have, of course, the best industrial policy in the form of TSIPAS with tailor-made incentives for mega projects. We have multiple world-class aerospace parks and SEZs adjacent to the outer ring road and airport. We also have large number of existing global aerospace OEMs into manufacturing and also into export. We have abundant skilled workforce and state advanced skilling partnerships. TASC, in partnership with Cranfield University, Aerocampus Aquitaine, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical Society, has been able to create a robust think force, robust workforce, which will continue to feed the aerospace and defense industry in Hyderabad, in Telangana. More than 1,000 MSMEs are integrated into the aerospace and defense supply chains in Hyderabad. The focus on innovation, the focus on growing more and more innovative ideas, grooming more services and products from our state through T-Hub, T-Works, Research and Innovation Circle of Hyderabad, V-Hub, the Women Entrepreneurs Hub, all of these together will continue to keep the state in good stead in terms of providing quality resources to this industry. Top ranks by the state in ease of doing business, in cost effectiveness, in all social indices also continue to attract investments into aerospace and defense. The state of Telangana has consistently won the biennial Best State Award from Ministry of Civil Aviation, Government of India, for the most progressive outlook towards aerospace sector in 2018, 2020, and also in 2022. Hyderabad was also ranked number one globally by FTFDA Aerospace Cities of Future Rankings in cost effectiveness metric. To meet the increasing demand, as Olivia pointed out, the civil aviation space continues to expand. The aviation traffic continues to go through the roof. In fact, our Hyderabad airport, led by GMR Group, is also on an expansion mode. And I'm hopeful that they will complete their terminal expansion by December. And I'm also hopeful the day is not too far, you know, when Hyderabad will have to create additional terminals to cater to the growth.